Hi.
Today, the topic of our discussion is solute, solvent, and solution. Here, you can see the particles of solute, and this is a solvent here. When these two combine together, we got a solution as a result. So, at first, let's talk about solute. A substance that is dissolved in a solution is actually called as a solute. In fluid solutions, the amount of solvent present is greater than the amount of solute. What does that mean? It means the amount of solute is smaller than the amount of solvent. One best example of solute in our day-to-day activity is salt and water. Salt dissolved in water, and therefore salt is solute here. As you can see, we are using salt here in a lesser quantity, in a smaller quantity, and moreover, salt is dissolving into the water, so that's why salt is a solute here. Then, by moving on, we have some other common examples of solute. Vinegar is obtained when we mix acetic acid in water. The amount of acetic acid we are using here is very small. Moreover, it is dissolving into the water. So that's why it is a solute here. Then sugar, water is formed by mixing sugar into water. So here, the amount of sugar is less than the amount of this solvent. And moreover, this sugar is dissolved into this water. That's why this is a solute here. So, by concluding, solute is something that is small in quantity and it is dissolved in the solution. By moving on, we have solvent. What is solvent? The part of a solution that is present in the greatest amount is called as a solvent. It's the liquid that the solute is dissolved in. Most of the time, solvent is in liquid state. One of the best examples of solvent in our day-to-day life is salt and water. Here, do remember, the salt is solute because it is in the smaller quantity. But the water here is present in the larger quantity, so it is a solvent. Moreover, it is a liquid that the solute dissolved in. That's why it is a solvent. We have some other common examples of solvent. Vinegar is obtained when we mix acetic acid in water. Now, acetic acid is in the smaller quantity and it is dissolved in water. So, acetic acid actually is a solute here, but water is a solvent here because it is in the larger quantity and it is in the liquid state also. Sugar, water is formed by mixing sugar in water. Now, what is water here? Water is the solvent here because at first it is present in the larger quantity and moreover, it is dissolving the sugar in itself. So, by concluding, what is solvent? Solvent is something that is present in larger quantity and in which the solute is dissolved. Now, what is a solution? A homogeneous mixture of two or more substances joined together physically is called as a solution. Solution is formed when solute and solvent are mixed together. But do remember, after mixing, the solution should be homogeneous. Homogeneous is actually a uniform solution in which the particles of solute are indivisible. Like, we are unable to see the particles of solute from our naked eye. When we make a salt solution, we can't see the particles of solute in that solution. In the next example, you can see sugar here. When we dissolve sugar into water, we are unable to see the particles of sugar there. Why? Because it is a homogeneous solution. So whenever by mixing the solute and solvent, if we get a homogeneous, a uniform mixture in which we can't see the particles of solute in the solution is called as solution. So homogeneity is the basic condition for every solution. Have a look at this example. Now this is solvent. Water is present here in the larger quantity. These are pebbles. They are acting as solute here because they are present in smaller quantity. But wait, This is not a solution. Why? Because you can see the particles of solute here from your necktie. If you can see the particles of solute from your naked eye, it means it's not a homogeneous mixture. It's not a uniform mixture. So it's not a solution also. Then we have some common examples of solution here. Have a look at these cold drinks. In these cold drinks, carbon dioxide, sugar and flavors are dissolved in water in order to form a solution. Now, carbon dioxide, sugar and flavors are present in a smaller quantity and water is acting as a solvent here because it is in the larger quantity, but it's a uniform solution. Then comes the next example, mouthwash. Mouthwash consists of number of chemicals that are dissolved in water. Now, what does that mean? It means chemicals are acting as solute here and water is acting as a solvent here. By mixing solute and solvent, we got a homogeneous mixture, and that homogeneous mixture is called as solution because it is uniform and we can't see the particles of solute with our naked eye. Then comes tincture of iodine is obtained by dissolving crystals of iodine in alcohol. Here, the crystals of iodine are acting as solute because they are dissolved in alcohol and they are in the small quantity also. And alcohol is acting as solvent here because they are in the larger quantity, a uniform mixture in which we can't see the crystals of iodine. So that's why this is also an example of solution. Now, let me tell you an interesting fact here. Water is act as a universal solvent. And why it's so? Because it is capable of dissolving more substances than any other liquid. So water has capability to dissolve many other substances into it. But these substances should be polar in nature. According to the rule, like dissolve like, because water is also polar in nature. So due to polarity of water, due to polar nature of water, it can just dissolve polar substances into itself. It is unable to dissolve non-polar substances. Say for example, if we are going to put some drops of oil into the water, oil is unable to dissolve in water. Why? Because oil is non-polar in nature, is polar in nature. So it dissolved many polar substances into itself. That's why water acts as a universal solvent. Concluding, here you can see the particles of solute. Solute is something that is smaller in quantity and moreover, it is dissolved in the solvent. Solvent is something that is larger in quantity and most of the time it is liquid. Moreover, it dissolves solute in itself. When solute and solvent mix together, if they make a homogeneous or a uniform mixture, then that homogeneous mixture is called as a solution. So this is all about solute, solvent, and solution. Do like, comment, subscribe, and follow this channel for more informative videos. Thank you.